Now let's look at how we can add a little bit of more intricate detail to the center part of the medallion. So let's say that we want to add sort of an embossed shape in the center here. And let's say that we either want to make it sort of filled with enamel paint, or maybe it's glowing, something like that. And so we'll do maybe a couple of different variations of this. So let's go ahead and just add a new paint layer here on our gold texture set. And then I want to come down and look at the alphas, and I want to choose an alpha that I want to put as a shape in the center here. And so this person is sort of a bird-like race. And so I'm going to choose maybe a couple that are, I feel like would go along with that theme or kind of fit with that aesthetic. And so for this first one, I'm going to use this circular triangle. And what I want to do is I want to add it to my brush. So if I just go ahead and double click on this, it's going to add that to the brush. If I right click, you can see where that is added. Right under the alpha, you can see that circular triangle listed there. Now we can come down and figure out what we want to actually affect. So we want to push this into the surface, and then we want to create, let's say in this case, we want to create kind of an enameled paint kind of a look of a color. And so let's actually go ahead and choose our base color. So let's make it kind of a red, something like that. And on the height, we'll go ahead and push that in a little bit. So we want it to be pushed down into the surface a bit. The roughness, we want it to be a little bit rougher. And you can see the effect as you go through, you'll see got kind of the preview of what that's going to look like. So actually maybe something like that. We don't want it to be metallic. And so we'll go with that. So once you've got that, you can come in, and now we can actually resize this without going into our settings, which you could do here as well. You could resize it here, but you can also resize it with some hotkeys. So if I hold down control and use the right mouse button, I can resize it to get it kind of in the center there. If you want to rotate it, you can just keep the control button down and use the left mouse button to rotate that around. And then I'm just simply going to click, and you can see it's pushed into the surface and it has that red color. Now it's not really covering enough of the surface to really get the effect of the material. We come in here, I'm going to push it in a little bit more. I'm going to darken up the color a bit, and let's take our roughness, something like that. And so we can start to add detail that way using an alpha with whatever shape. You could obviously bring one of these in. It's just a black and white image. You could use your own, create your own. Now, right now, and you can see the reflection on that, we're able to get a different kind of reflectivity, okay, the roughness on that. But what if we wanted to be a little bit more techy, and maybe we wanted to actually emit light? Well, we can do that, but we have to add another channel. So if you go through and you create some variations and you want to try one that's sort of a glow effect of this, let's create a new layer, and we'll make it a paint layer. We need to go ahead and modify this a little bit. So with our gold selected, we're going to go into the texture set settings. All we have to do is come down to channels, and I want to add a new channel. So I'll click the plus, and I want to add an emissive channel. So now on this new layer, we're going to go get another alpha. And so let's come down, and actually I'm going to use this arrow right here. All right. And I'm going to rotate it around, so it's kind of pointing straight up, be something like that. All right. Let me turn off this first layer. The flexible way that you work with layers is really nice because you can really try some different things. So here, let's go in, and I'm going to change this base color to more of a blue. And you can see that it still has a roughness, so it's getting it's receiving light and reflecting light. And so what we want to do is make this instead an emissive. And so we'll turn on emissive, and if we come down here, turn on the emissive. Now when we go in and select our color, I'm going to go in and select this blue. Okay, we can take our roughness all the way up. And now the interior of this is going to sort of glow or have that glowing kind of a look. Okay, so now when we come in, and I'm going to actually push this in a little bit more. So get it lined up, and let's create one. And so that will actually let you create kind of a glowing effect where you've got an emissive look that can give you a little bit more of either like a magical look or effect, or more of a techie look or effect. And again, if you don't like that one, you can go back to the other one. You can kind of see the difference where that one looks a little bit more like it's been painted in versus this one that is a little bit more kind of illuminated. If you don't like the placement, you can always go in, either get rid of this. You could go in and erase everything, add it back in, maybe if we were a little bit too low. And you could continue to add to that as well. For instance, you know, you could just load in another alpha if you wanted to add something, maybe a circle to the center or something like that. Or if you had one, you know, one like this, you could come in here and scale this down and add something like that. Okay. Again, you can design your own shape and bring it in as a black and white image, and then put any of those images kind of inside there. So the next thing that we want to do is to go in and texture the blue sash here. So we want to use kind of a repeating pattern, but we don't want it to affect the color necessarily. We want it to really be subtle and just affect the roughness. And so we'll take a look at that next.